Hi there, my name is Andy Knieven, Minecraft Education Community Program Manager, and you are wonderfully you. But together, we are going to learn how to facilitate Minecraft Education's Hour of AI the first night. So I've gathered my torch to be able to guide us, whether you are a parent, a teacher, an advisor, a sponsor, a coach, whatever your role is. I'm so glad that you have joined in and join me on our mission to empower future generations to build a better world. And as we are experiencing a world with AI already integrated into it, we are constantly learning more about how AI can, will, and continue to be part of it. I have kind of front-loaded and created in Microsoft Edge this, you know, series of tabs that I'm going to toggle through. But today we're going to explore where to find all the resources that you need to lead and facilitate this wonderful world. All of that can be found at aka.ms/hour of AI. So if you open a new tab and you follow along, more power to you. But we'll go through and explore those resources. We may not go through every page, read everything together. That's for you to be able to have, but I want to share and show where to find what you need. And then I'll talk about how to facilitate this with your students. And then at the end, we'll be able to go through a playthrough and I'll show you how to navigate the actual world, the Hour of AI, the first night. So going to aka.ms/hour of AI, you'll find yourself here. In this space, think of this as your one-stop shop of all the resources that you need. You're going to have this amazing trailer that's really going to bring a lot of hype and excitement with your students, but then also to have that blog to kind of read more about where we've been with the Hour of Code over the last decade, and now we are at the Hour of AI. Talking about how to play, where to find Minecraft Education. You can, if you already have the game on your device, simply launch the app, launch the game, and you'll be able to go to the lesson library, go to the new and featured, launch the Hour of AI right there in the game. But if you don't have Minecraft Education already downloaded, you can get it here, and you'll be able to see that the Hour of AI, the first night, is part of the demo lesson space that you have free access to. So let me show you more about how to find that there. So downloading Minecraft Education is a free thing. Once you download it and you launch the game, it'll prompt you to sign in. But below that button, there's a link here that says, if you don't have an account, try a demo lesson. So going through that step there, it's going to give you the chance to view the terms, accept them, and then select play. In here, you're then going to see it download, launch the game, and you'll select start lesson. And we have an amazing opportunity here where we can learn about AI in many different ways. And with Minecraft Education, there are many maps and worlds to be able to do that. And so this time we are going to talk about the Hour of AI, the first night, and with agentic AI to be able to train our agents to help us survive. And I say agents because we will have many agents to help us survive the first night, which is a very common thing that our students may experience playing Minecraft in surviving that first challenge in survival mode, is to survive the first night, gathering the resources they need, crafting tools, building a structure, and then a bed potentially to survive that first night. So many students will be really excited to be like, oh, this is just like, you know, Bedrock or Java that they've experienced before. Now we have a lot of fun, but learning about AI and coding as well. Talking about coding, we will choose our programming language that we will be following along. In here, you have Block or Python. I encourage you, especially for this one, start off with Block. Whether your students have played Minecraft Education before, the Hour of Code before, and they're like, oh, I've done this, I'm ready to be, you know, an expert and do Python, I'd encourage them, do Block first. The Python choice on here is definitely more advanced than any Python Hour of Code world before. So with the Hour of AI, the Python one is definitely at that expert level. Now, going back to our page here, we'll also then see we have all the additional resources that we need to facilitate a lesson or an event. I would encourage you to start off by going to facilitator training, and that is going to bring us to Microsoft Learn and go through this module. It's really going to give you a lot of background and great insight of the resources that you need, the background about the Hour of Code and now the Hour of AI, the FAQ that you may have, going beyond it with the build challenge. And so I encourage you, go through this first facilitator module here on Microsoft Learn, but the next one will be then to go to the lesson plan. So going to the lesson plan, you're gonna find yourself here at the top of the page, and you'll then scroll down to find your learning objectives. And you'll then have all of these little menus that you can expand on the prep notes, how to install, taking that facilitator course that I just showed, reviewing the educator guide, and I'll talk about that, playing it yourself, but then having those solutions, all these guiding ideas, talking about the core concepts, the standards that you can address, the student activities. Really, you're gonna follow a series of events, and it's always going to kind of go into a loop as well. You're going to collect wood, make tools, build a shelter, craft a door, add light, and make a bed. But in every single one of those, just like as parents, as teachers, as advisors, sponsors, coaches, we kind of do that series. I do, we do, you do. So I'm going to do something. Our agent will observe us, just like our students in that case will observe us. And then it's going to ask questions. It's going to say, I think I can do that. It'll verify that it did it correctly with you. And so you have to train the agent to go through that, and then it's going to go do it itself. We're going to do the same process as we facilitate this with our students. I encourage you, and I'll talk about the getting started with the first stage where we do it as a class, and then you let your students go do the rest of the world on their own. Again, scrolling through, you have all these additional references and resources, but scrolling back up along the right side of the page, all these supporting files are really where you're going to find some great information. These presentation slides are student facing. And so going here, this is the PowerPoint deck. You can go in here, customize it to fit your unique needs and students in your classroom community. And just like I said, you're going to have that I do, we do, you do. You're also going to gather what do they already know about AI robots and information that they're living and experiencing in their everyday lives. Having them talk about, have they experienced anything like a smart device or AI? And then what's one thing that you like to train AI to help you complete? Because all of these additional questions help make a deeper impact with our students. Continuing on, we'll talk about what the objective, what we're going to be doing in here. But I encourage you, take a moment with your students and talk about the vocabulary. What is artificial intelligence? Classification? And all these terms are things that the agent is going to bring up and talk about throughout the gameplay, recognizing that you're training it and it can be proactive, learning from patterns. But orchestration is another key term that may puzzle your students maybe, but it's the idea that we are all working together like a team. AI makes sure different parts do their jobs at the right time, just like a coach or a conductor leads a band or an orchestra. So that's orchestration. And then always having that human in the loop for verification to make sure that what we're training the agent to do is doing it correctly with the right guidance from us as a human. And that's, again, going back to that ethical part of how we use AI. Now, coming back to the slides here, again, you can go through, click through them with your students. And again, going through what the steps are that they are going to have. But I, again, talking about that very first stage, I do, we do, you do. That loop is going to continue to go throughout the gameplay that the agent is going to be doing with you as the player. So it's going to observe you, and then it's going to verify it's doing it correctly. You confirm it, and it goes and does it. So when you get started on this first stage, have your students do all of this together with you, leading it, facilitating it. And then after this first stage, after they collect wood, then they can go do the rest of the world on their own. Now, as you go through and start crafting tools, one of the things that you may experience is maybe like on crafting tools, you need sticks and you need planks. But then if you use too many sticks to make multiple axes or multiple shovels or multiple pickaxes, you won't have enough sticks to make the other items. So, or the other tools. So on the agent, you'll notice that there's that little return arrow that you'll notice above it. So after it, you start that, a 10 second countdown will begin. Not that it's on screen, but after that, that arrow will appear. If for some reason you use too many sticks or too many planks and craft too many tools and you won't have enough to make the other ones that you need a shovel, a pickaxe, and an axe. If you have made too many of one, you won't have enough of the items to make the others. You can reset that and it'll give you back what you need to then go back and craft the proper amount of tools that will help you advance through that stage. So that's what that arrow is. Definitely a helpful tip on navigating that. Again, scrolling through, you'll have all the additional steps that you will need to take. And all of this, again, something that you can customize to make it fit your classroom audience. Now, going back to our lesson plan, we have our educator guide. And so looking at our educator guide here, this is going to be where it breaks down all the things that we as educators, look for as we lead a lesson. What are the objectives? What are the standards that can cover all the steps? But for many educators or facilitators, maybe this is the first time you're ever seeing Minecraft. So definitely take a moment. Look at this visual glossary. What is the hotbar? It's the bottom thing at the bottom of the gameplay screen. Your agent is your helper friend, the book, the differences of different kinds of logs, and then how then you have planks, your inventory, the crafting grid, which is what opens up after you open and select with the crafting table, what sticks, what a wooden axe looks like, all of these additional pieces and what they mean, even a torch. I've got one right here too. So as you go through, these all visual glossary page will help you understand what your students will see and need to do as well. And then from this point on, it goes through step by step through the entire gameplay. So if maybe you print it, you'll see that that is, you know, multiple pages. So if you print it, or if this is digital where you can swipe through or scroll through as well. Looking back at our facilitator, space here in the lesson plan, there's additional resources here for solutions. So let's dive into those solutions. In the solution guide, we see that we have every step, every answer to help us if a student were to get stuck. That happens. So what each successful stage will look like as you train your agent, what block looks like as the answer, and then Python. And I'll go through the gameplay and show how we can check that with the little light bulb in that coding space as well. But every single one of these has those resources or has the answer as a resource and a reference for you to help you lead and facilitate this with your students. Back at the lesson plan page, there's a facilitator guide link, which is pretty much what we've been talking about here on how to lead an hour of AI. This is a great resource to be able to share if you're a teacher with an instructional assistant, a parent, a club sponsor, and an advisor to help them run an effective and successful hour of AI. Back at that lesson plan page, there is a certificate of completion and an Hour of AI sticker, both great digital downloads that you could take and use to be able to celebrate your students and why not do it for yourself. But at the end of completing the world, the Hour of AI, the first night, there is a option when you hit escape or you hit those three bars, if you're on a touch device, it'll open up the ability to get a certificate. It'll take you here to code.org, which is a great partner that we have, to be able to enter your name and get that certificate. But you'll also see at code.org, there is all kinds of additional connections with Minecraft Worlds to learn about Hour of AI activities. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't share one more resource for you to be able to communicate with your school community. And that is this aka.ms/HOAI25_communication-tool. This is a great space to be able to have pre-made prompts or messaging for you to share about what you're doing in your school community with your classroom newsletters, school messaging, direct messages with families, but also to have some great art or images to be able to project in your classroom to create a great environment and atmosphere, but also to have frames to say, I survived the night. Going back to that main page, as we scroll down, you're facilitating this, but you're not alone. There is an amazing global community that you can connect with. And so on here, I encourage you, I invite you personally to connect with us in our Minecraft Education Teachers Lounge. And so this is where global educators all around the world support, connect, and celebrate each other. But there's additional resources and events that you can connect with, like a playthrough. Just like I said, there are many ways to learn about AI, and lucky for you, we have this awesome opportunity with Minecraft Education to do so in many different maps and worlds in the game. And of course, scrolling through, it's not just a game. We have all kinds of additional resources. And so in the AI Foundations page here, I want to share and show that we have all kinds of additional pages, like Agent and Chicken are great friends, but again, additional resources and even an entire curriculum guide for you to share. Maybe something to send along to maybe an admin that you have.